The opinions expressed in the video you are about to see are solely those of BoatTest.com and its test captain.
Hi, Captain Steve for BoatTest.com. Today, I'm going to be conducting a full test and performance review on a powerful contender for the offshore fishing market. It's the 327cc from Intrepid Powerboats. Now, this 327 isn't necessarily filling a gap in the Intrepid lineup, as it is filling a need for the boat to better carry the larger V8 engines. To do that, Intrepid made some subtle improvements to the 323 hull to create this 327. Let's take a look.
As we come around the stern, we can see some of the significant changes that this 327 has over the 323 to accommodate the heavier engines. First and foremost, the larger engine well. It's been expanded and enlarged, so it gives you a little more flotation. And as you look at the dead rise, it has been flattened about a degree from the 323, so that will also give you a little more buoyancy. Intrepid has also added two additional steps behind their main step in the running surface, so these will inject more air under the running surface and again improve buoyancy for the added weight of the V8 engines. We've got a twin V8 installation on this boat. You can go twin V6s or triple V6s, up to 900 horsepower total. If you go with triple engines, then you're going to lose the dive door at the stern. Let's take a look at the helm. As you can see, we've got plenty of real estate, 35 inches, so you can easily put two 15-inch displays. You've got the three multifunction Yamaha gauges. There's a collective trim on the engine control and individual trim controls, and I only found that I needed the individual trim controls for leveling the boat for an uneven distribution of weight. Trim tabs, stainless steel wheel with a steering knob. Underneath, windlass control. Here's another improvement from the 323, where the switches used to be in this box so that they would stay dry. Now, Intrepid has gone with stainless steel switches that are rated IP65, which means not only are they waterproof, they're submersible to 15 feet. They're also backlit when they're activated, and the bilge pump switches are lighted in red. Underneath, a molded footrest, and this footrest will come out for easy access to the batteries. Up above, compartment for putting stuff, and notice how it's draining. I'd like to see the compass move in front of the helm. I'm happy to see that Intrepid got the size of the console right. Usually in a boat in this size and class, I've got to stand on my toes to see over the console, but not so on this boat. The console's low enough where I can actually have a clear view of the bow, let alone beyond the bow.
The Intrepid 327 center console had a length of 32 feet 7 inches and a beam of 9 feet 6 inches. With an empty weight of 9,500 pounds, half fuel and three people on board, we had a test weight of 10,925 pounds. The twin Yamaha F350 V8 four-strokes reached a max RPM of 5,700, which brought us to a top speed of 55.5 knots. At that speed, we were burning a total of 63.6 gallons per hour for a range of 181 nautical miles. Best cruise came in at 3,000 RPM, where we were running at 25.8 knots while burning 17.8 gallons per hour. That gave us a range of 301 nautical miles, of course with a 10% reserve. We had a quick time to plane of 3.2 seconds, reached 20 miles per hour in 5.8 seconds, 30 miles an hour in 8.7 seconds, 40 in 12.4 seconds, and continued accelerating through 50 miles an hour in 16.3 seconds. Not surprisingly, the Yamaha V8s ran very quietly. I measured only 60 decibels at idle speed, with the sound level peaking at 97 decibels at wide open throttle, but that was mostly due to the wind noise that was contributing to this.
When you hit the throttle on the 327, the bow comes up about 10 degrees, but because I'm so short and the boat is so long, I did lose sight of the horizon for about 4 or 5 seconds before the bow came down. Trimming the 327 is very straightforward. Once you get up on plane, you're going to start bringing the trim up a little bit. You're going to feel a boost in performance, but you won't necessarily see a change in attitude or in the spray coming out the sides of the boat. Always when I get on a boat with a stepped hull, I question whether it's going to have a good turning performance, because when you put so much air under the hull, it tends to be a little bit slippery, but nothing could be further from the truth with the 327. When I put it into a turn, it stayed glued to the turn like it was on rails, put in about a 10 degree bank, and as it came around, I did bleed off an awful lot of speed. So the trick is, just before you went to the turn, you drop the engines down, add power to carry you through the turn, and then as you straighten out, you can bring the trim back up again.
That's our look at the performance capabilities of the 327 center console from Intrepid. For BoatTest.com, I'm Captain Steve. We'll see you on the water.